we went into the harbor itself, you'll find some tourist attractions there.
The USS Trenton is one of the museum ships that sit along this area. And you can actually go on there, and here you see one of the helicopter that's on it.
This is a museum dedicated to oil rigs, and you can actually go in and see how these offshore oil rigs operate. Very interesting. There's an area right along the docks there that is an entertainment complex with lots of great restaurants like Landry's Oyster Bar, as you see there. And Pier 1 imports some shopping. Of course, Sue had to find the shopping.
Well, of course.
As you can see, the Trenton kind of dominates the skyline of this port, at this part of the port.
The boats that you see here are people that just are coming in for lunch.
Mm-hmm. There's a lucky pup. Comes in for lunch on a pretty nice looking boat.
You can dine al fresco, or you can dine inside. This particular day, we chose to go inside and have a wonderful meal.
As you can see, again, the atmosphere is very casual, very relaxed.
This whole area is the Texas Seaport Museum and the 1877 tall ship Elissa. And you can actually go out on this ship if you're 12 years and older. And you can spend a day climbing the rigging and unfurling the sails, as you'll see as we sit here.
Galveston Harbor is also the home to Carnival Cruise Lines.
We saw the celebration while we were there.
And if you're thinking about a trip during the winter, why, this is probably one of the ports you might consider. Back to the Elissa. This ship is one of only three operating tall ships now in the United States. And it is really a sight to behold. There's some of those folks climbing around and learning how to rig a sailboat.
This is what they call a square-rigged 400-ton barkentine, it's called. Actually, it was built in Scotland in 1877.
Some people say it's a great way to learn about old ships. Others say it's a great way to build your leg muscles.
Definitely. When we were sitting there, we were having lunch, and we were watching the people climb up and down this. I would do this. I would climb up and down this because I really like heights. But look closely. You don't see a whole lot of safety belts on these people. I think you probably have to sign a waiver when you get on.
Oh, I would imagine so, yeah. Oh, look at that bow head there.
Very majestic. Well, they have such temperate climates there year-round.
And again, it was a beautiful day.
And this was the time of the year that we were here, I think it was around November.
Right, it was. We celebrated a family birthday. What a majestic ship.
Now you can see some of the tall ships like this. Boston sometimes has the Tall Ships Festival, and also Chicago.
From there, just a short walk down the harbor is Fishermans Wharf, where we went for lunch.
I think I found what I want to have to eat. Crab and avocado dip served with salsa and tortilla chips, and the strand salad, jumbo lump crab meat, and blackened shrimp for a Caesar salad. Here we are in Galveston at the Fishermans Wharf Seafood Grill.
Just page after page of great stuff on the Fisherman Wharf menu here. We're sitting right next to the Elissa, the tall ship. Carnival Cruise Line celebration is right over here. The museum, the oil derrick, the rig, everything. I mean, this is a great place to come see as a tourist. Probably the best part of Galveston Island until we get back to see and show you some of the old mansions. They are just great. I'm looking forward to that. But right now, the fried calamari, that's always got to be good, but there's a shrimp combo for the house special. generous portions of Gulf shrimp prepared three ways. Mama Rosie's style, which is lightly sautéed and fried, sautéed in a Dijon cream sauce, and grilled shrimp served with vegetables and new potatoes. And I think that's got my name all over it.
Ooh, yum. That does sound good.
Yep. Here come the appetizers now. Let's see what we got. This is, oh, yeah. Lump crab meat. Looks like guacamole, salsa. Let's see, I'll try the guacamole. Pardon my fingers. Oh, yeah.
Good stuff?
This is going to be a good lunch.
Well, I'm going to join you.
This is going to be a real good lunch.
And they keep bringing out all these wonderful, tempting desserts. All right, Kevin, what'd you decide?
Oh, that bread pudding looks delicious, but you want to split a piece of pecan pie?
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Hi, St. Louis!
Friendly folks in
yes,
Galveston.
They were.
Now, watch closely, and you're going to see dolphins actually playing in the bay. There's one.
And they'll come right up alongside the boats.
That was amazing.
And we were sitting at our table at the restaurant when we saw them.
Here's another look at the Elissa. I was just fascinated by this ship.
It is there just about all year round, but if you are going specifically to see it, then call ahead and make sure it's not out to sea. The Ashton Villa, oh, that was a beautiful one. That was in 1859, and it's an Italianate reflecting the opulence of the era.
Yeah, Galveston Island was originally inhabited by the Indians, then the French and the Spanish, and these mansions are incredible.
The Moody Mansion that you just saw here, this is an 1892 red brick with Texas limestone and terracotta on the tile, and it's what's called a transitional Victorian architecture. It has 42 rooms, 28,000 square feet.
Gingerbread house. I wonder why they call it that.
Yeah, really.
These are some of the other homes that you'll find along there. Originally, Galveston was known as St. Louis. Not many people know that. But when it was founded for King Louis, and then was changed at a later date. Sue likes all of these colored houses.
This is kind of like the painted lady style of the Victorian homes in like, let's say, Eureka
Look
Springs.
At that.
Isn't that gorgeous? That is a pretty one.
Not unlike New Orleans, you have the moss hanging in the trees and these old Victorian mansions. Oh.
And this is just one of the streets that we drove down. You can take a walking tour, a driving tour in your own car, or a horse and carriage ride, too.
Now, if you noticed how these houses are on piers, a lot of them were raised after that storm in 1900. When they built the seawall, they actually raised these houses up and built piers under them.
How about this for an aloe plant? It's got to be at least 6 feet tall.
I'm 5'4", so that has to definitely be over 6.
I guess they do make them big in Texas.
The J.C. Truby Castle, as they call it, is also a B&B.
This fellow was originally from Denmark and had, this is concrete over brick. I think there's 12 gables, and one of the things is a false fireplace that as you look to it or through it is actually a stained glass window from the inside.
That would be unique.
Well, either on your way to or from Galveston, you've got to stop here at NASA headquarters. It's right in between, and a lot of things for the whole family to do, kids and adults as well. Now, they take space shuttle really seriously here. As you can see behind me, there is a McDonald's space shuttle playground. with the pilot, Ronald McDonald, and the NASA emblem on the tail.
NASA is about 20 miles out of Houston, so on your way to Galveston, you can make a stop there and see.
It's just about halfway.